Third part of pharmaceutical impurities is control of impurities. In this section, we will discuss about how the impurities can be controlled. First method is pharmacopoeial methods for the control of impurities. In this case, first topic is official monograph of pharmaceutical substances provides description and information in addition to prescribing standards for the product and its storage conditions. An official monograph for a pharmaceutical substance generally includes the following. First one, title, chemical formula, chemical name, category, dose. Description, solubility, storage, standards as determined by the assay, identification test, test for purity, and lastly, assay about that compounds. So, in case of title, it is the official name of the substance. Sometimes the common names or synonyms are also mentioned. In chemical formula, when the chemical structure of the compound is known, the graphic and molecular formula and the molecular weight are given following the title. A chemical formula refers to the chemically pure substance and is not an indication of purity of the substance. Chemical names. Sometimes the IUPAC name of the substance is also given. Category. It is indicative of the medical or pharmaceutical application of the substance. Dose. The dose mentioned in the pharmacopoeia are for the general guidance and they represents the average range of quantities regarded suitable for adults when administered orally. Description. In this section, it gives the information regarding the general physical and organoleptic properties of the substance. It helps in preliminary evaluation of the integrity of the article and should be not be considered as the analytical requirements. Next is solubility. The solubility of substance given in the monograph is primarily for information and should not be regarded as a standards or test for purity. But if a quantitative solubility is given under standards, then the substance should comply with the given requirement. If the exact solubility of substance is not known, the approximate solubility of the substance is indicated by the descriptive terms. Following table gives the meaning of such descriptive terms for substances at 20 to 30 degree Celsius. Various descriptive terms and approximate volume of the solvent for one part of solute. Very soluble means less than one part, freely soluble from 1 to 10 parts, soluble 10 to 30 parts, sparingly soluble 30 to 100 parts, slightly soluble 100 to 1000, very slightly 1000 to 10,000, and insoluble or practically insoluble, that is more than 10,000 parts. Storage. It contains information regarding the storage condition of pharmaceutical substances so that they can be guarded against possible contamination and deterioration. The precautions need to be taken regarding the effect of atmosphere, moisture, heat and light are also indicated where appropriate in the individual monograph. The temperature conditions related to the storage of pharmaceutical substances are specified in some monographs. According to IP, cold means any temperature not exceeding 8 degrees Celsius and usually between 2 and 8 degrees Celsius, then it is called as cold temperature. A refrigerator is a cold place in which temperature is maintained thermostatically between 2 and 8 degrees Celsius. Next is cool. That means any temperature between 8 degrees Celsius and 25 degrees Celsius is termed to be cool. An article directed to be stored in cool place may alternatively be stored in a refrigerator unless otherwise specified in the monograph. Room temperature, the temperature prevailing in the working area, that is known as room temperature. Warm, any temperature between 30 degrees Celsius and 40 degrees Celsius, that is need to be warm, that is called as warm. Excessive heat, any temperature above 40 degrees Celsius is called as excessive heat. Protection from freezing, the label of container bears these instructions where in addition to the risk of breaking of the container, freezing results in a loss of strength or potency of or indestructive alteration of the characteristics of an article. Storage under non-specific conditions, when no specific storage conditions are indicated in the monograph, the storage conditions include protection from moisture, freezing and excessive heat. Standards as determined by the assay, it specifies the quantitative purity of the official compound. If an article does not comply with all the standard requirement, it is not of pharmacopeial quality. Identification tests, it includes various chemical tests to verify the identity of substance. They are not absolute proof of identity. Next, tests for purity including limit test. Different limits for impurities are prescribed for different substances. Tests for purity are tests for the presence of impurities in the substance and fix the limits of tolerance for undesirable impurities. Assay, it describes the official method for the quantitative determination of the product or active ingredient of the pharmaceutical substance and its preparations. Identification test, the purpose of identification test is to ensure the correct labeling of the substances. Identification tests are specific, but they are not necessarily sufficient in establishing the absolute proof of identity of the substance. If the article taken from labeled container do not meet to the requirements of a prescribed identification test, indicates that article is either mislabeled or substituted. In same monographs, more than one identification tests are given. In such cases, if the article complies with the either one or other identification test in sufficient to verify the identity of the article. Identification tests are generally based upon the combination of simple chemical test and measurement of appropriate physical constants. There is a considerable overlap between identification test and limit test. Limit tests are designed to ensure that the undesirable impurities are within the prescribed limits. Identification tests, whether physical or chemical provided, they are sufficiently specific and can be used as the basis of quantitative estimation or in the design of a specific limit test. Practically, a single identification test may contribute to identification as well as standardization of the substances. Chemical tests used for identification are basically qualitative, confirming to the presence of the substance under investigation. They may be far too general or lack specificity, but be considered sufficiently specific when used in the conjugation with the other requirement of the monograph. Physical constants such as melting point, boiling point, solubility, weight per mole, refractive index, etc. have characteristics value for a given substance. They can be used in identification, checking quality, and maintaining standards of purity. These are the references which has been followed for the presentation for preparing the presentation. In the next presentation, we will study about the tests for purity. Thank you again for your patience listening.